Hi everybody, this is Crystal Proxmire of Oakland County Times, and we're here today with Marcia Squire, who is running for state representative in the 57th district. How are you today?
I'm great. Thank you for inviting me.
Well, thanks for doing this. Can you tell us, because we have redistricting, this is an all new district, what communities are in the 57th?
So the 57th is roughly Western Sterling Heights, plus portions of Troy and Madison Heights. The portions between like DeQuinder and John R., just across the edge, but essentially from Van Dyke to John R., 14 mile to Hall Road, which is like 20 mile road. So it's a pretty small district. And I myself am in Sterling Heights.
So why have you decided to run?
So I decided to run to help get big money and corporate influence out of politics. I think that our corporations already have more than enough representation in our legislators, in our legislation and, you know, and just overall. So I'm running on a people-friendly, non-corporate campaign to help get representation for the people back, you know, to a better level in Lansing.
So what are some of the things that you'd like to work on if you're elected?
So my four main priorities are healthcare, infrastructure, renewables, and education, which is an acronym form, HIRE and then SQUIRE. So that's, you know, a good way to remember those four key points. I want to expand healthcare, Medicaid and Medicare both. And I want to obviously work on infrastructure improvements and really focus Michigan's energy efforts on renewable resources, including water. You know, we do have the Great Lakes, and then obviously education as well. I want to extend publicly funded education to include higher education as well.
So can you tell us a bit about your professional experience and what skills you bring to the table?
Yeah, so I'm currently a training manager for a valet company. It's roughly mid-level management type of work. I've got some supervisors and some valets below me, and then the general manager and the owner above me. And actually, I do kind of like that. It's a good fit for me because I like having some of the added responsibility, but not necessarily all of it like the business owner would have. You know, I do like to go home at the end of the day and relax. I'm not trying to take my job home with me. So I think that helps. I'm currently in charge of about 60 employees, and this is not my first management job. My job prior to that, I was also a similar type of manager. So I work well with teams. I work well with people, and I have a Bachelor of Science degree in psychology as well, because I'm just, you know, I'm a people person, not necessarily a people pleaser, but a people person. I really like people. I enjoy people. I enjoy learning about people and, you know, especially the different backgrounds and diversities that like Metro Detroit has to offer.
So what are some of the ways that you've been involved in the community?
So on occasion, I do pro bono DJ services for charities like churches and schools, you know, like a daddy daughter dance or a walkathon or something, church fun fest. I do those free of charge. And then also previously I was the secretary for a middle school PTC for my oldest daughter, who is 20 now, but that's a different point. And then I was also on a local board of directors for Ingleside Grossdale Park Association. It's a private park on Lake St. Clair. I was chairman of the board and second vice president elected from 2013 to 2018 on that. And it's just a small neighborhood board of about 300 families, volunteer position that I enjoy doing as part of my community.
So in this race, there is some competition both in the primary and in November. Why should the voters pick you?
Well, I'm hoping that they decide to vote for me because they agree with me that we need to get big money and corporate influence out of politics. I'm the only outspoken candidate on these issues and, you know, just running on that type of platform. Both of my opponents in the primary and the general are both lawyers. And, you know, I feel that lawyers should stay in the judicial branch, just like I feel like military members should stay in the executive branch and maybe aspire to a cabinet position someday in their career. I feel that the legislation should be citizens and not necessarily lawyers, but obviously well-informed citizens that have access to the type of information like, you know, a lawyer on staff could provide.
So if people want more information about you and your campaign, where can they go?
They can search me online. I have run for office previously, so there's plenty of information available on Google or YouTube. I believe this might even be on YouTube as well. So if you search Marcia Squire, MarciaSquier, you'll be able to find plenty of information. I'm also on Twitter at @_Marcia. Like Marcia, 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 you know, just say my name three times and then vote for me. And also hiresquire.com is my website.
Great. Well, thank you so much for doing the interview with us today.
Thank you for having me. Enjoy your holiday weekend.